In our previous video, we learned how to evaluate limits using the method of direct substitution. Today, we will learn three more useful methods in evaluating limits. When evaluating limits using the direct substitution method, most of the time we will get an indeterminate form. When we get an indeterminate form, it means that the limit does not exist. Have a look at this example. Here, we are asked to find the limit of x plus 5 whole thing squared minus 25 divided by 2x as x tends to 0. If we use the direct substitution method, we get 0 plus 5 whole thing squared minus 25 divided by 2 into 0. So this gives us the answer 0 divided by 0. Since the denominator is 0, it is an indeterminate form. If we get any of these answers when evaluating limits, then we have an indeterminate form. However, just because we got an indeterminate form when using the direct substitution method, it does not mean that this function has no limit. We can try using other methods to find the limit. If we take the same example as before, we can first open the bracket. This gives us x squared plus 10x plus 25 minus 25 divided by 2x. So then we can cancel off 25 and also take x common from these two terms. That would be x into x plus 10 divided by 2x. Now we can cancel off the common x from the numerator and denominator. Remember, one important thing here is to mention that x is not equal to 0. Because if x is equal to 0, then it is mathematically wrong to cancel off 0 from the numerator and denominator. Many students fail to mention this important step. Now we apply the direct substitution into our limit. So finally we get our answer 5. So in this function, the limit does exist. Another method of evaluating limits is by cancelling the common factor. Let's take this example. Limit of x squared minus 4 divided by x minus 2 as x tends to 2. First, we try our direct substitution method. We will get 2 squared minus 4 divided by 2 minus 2. This will give us 0 divided by 0. Since this is not an answer we want, we can try evaluating it even more. The numerator here is in the form a squared minus b squared. Here, 4 can be written as 2 squared. So from algebra, we know that this can be factorized into a plus b into a minus b. So here we can write this as x plus 2 into x minus 2. Then we cancel off the common x minus 2 from the numerator and denominator. We must mention here that x minus 2 is not equal to 0. This means that x is not equal to 2. So after that, using direct substitution, we can get our final answer 2 plus 2, that is 4. The final method that we are going to learn today is by using the conjugate. Let's take this example. Here we are asked to find the limit of square root of x plus 3 minus 3 divided by x minus 6 as x tends to 6. By direct substitution, we get 0 divided by 0. So we try another method. Whenever there is a square root in a question, most of the time we use the conjugate. So what we do is we multiply the numerator and the denominator by the conjugate. So the conjugate here is square root of x plus 3 plus 3. It is the same as this. The only difference is that there is plus instead of minus. Now we can see here that the numerator is in the form a minus b into a plus b. So like previously, we can make this as a squared minus b squared. So square root of x plus 3 whole thing squared will be x plus 3. Minus 3 squared will be minus 9. That would be x plus 3 minus 9 gives us x minus 6. So we can cancel off x minus 6 from the numerator and the denominator. We must mention here that x minus 6 is not equal to 0. So that means x is not equal to 6. So then we can finally use the direct substitution method for 1 over square root of x plus 3 plus 3. This gives us 1 divided by 6. So those are some of the methods we use in evaluating limits. This might seem a little bit hard at first, but we have many exercises for you to try and become familiar in using these methods. The answers are also given for your reference. The only way you can become good at math is by attempting more and more sums. There is no other shortcut for this. That's all for today's video. Until we meet again, take care.